You're in full-time studies or a full-time job, yet you want to continue to upskill, level up, whether it be to learn how to code, learn a new language, programming, or maybe just spoken, learn something new. But there's one problem. There is no time to do it. We've all been there before when our schedules are slammed, we feel like there's nothing else to take on, yet we want to get ahead. We see these people on social media wondering, how do they do it all? Where does all the time come from? They have families, they have kids, we have families, we are busy. How does everyone do it all in order to get ahead? Maybe you want to get ahead for financial reasons, maybe it's to level up in your career, build a business, whatever the case may be. One of the biggest challenges that I personally have faced, and I know a lot of you have faced as well, hearing from you about it, is where to find the time. How to balance either full-time studies, a full-time job, while learning something new. Today I'm going to share with you just how I managed to have a full-time job, run a business, and also continue to learn. I did a video like this a while back, and I really wanted to make another one because there was a lot of follow-up questions from it, mainly around, well, Tiff, I'm doing all of these things, I'm managing my time, but I'm not seeing results. So I want to talk to you today about some unconventional ways to really manage your time and stay focused. And actually, you know what? We're gonna get into that more later. I'm not gonna give all my secrets away right away, but I wanted to share this video with you. I hope you find this, my experience, very valuable. I've had to use a lot of these techniques, time management and learning on the side while continuing to go full speed on whatever it is on your other side is something that I've had to do throughout my entire life, basically. From graduating high school, I remember I was in fashion, studying fashion while modeling on the side, learning that aspect. Then it transitioned from modeling full-time and then on the side learning how to code. And it was always one of the biggest factors in my success thus far, success whatever you want to call it, meaning reaching my goals, exceeding my goals, has been able to find balance and find this way of having something going on full-time while successfully managing a few other things on the side. Okay, let's get into it. Oh, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. You know the drill. Comment down below other videos you want me to cover. This is how I make these videos. And as always, I answer every single one of your questions that you leave down below. So leave questions down below and I'll make sure to get to them. Now let's go. Okay, we are gonna go get a coffee, catch up, coffee and chat, and kind of do what I'm talking about, which is balancing time, doing things. Actually, I'm not a fan of doing multiple things at once, but in this case, you know, it's fun, it's personable. But for the most part, multitasking is one of the biggest ways to fail, actually. Okay, I decided to end up actually at the grocery store, so I'll take you grocery shopping with me here quickly. But long story short, multitasking, when I was speaking about that just a second ago, the problem with it is that too often than not, we end up doing a lot of things at once really poorly. And this is something I used to do while trying to maintain my studies and then also learning on the side. For example, I was going to school for graphic communications management and then also learning coding on the side. So studying while learning a new skill. And I oftentimes would try and find times during my lecture or on my lunch break to fit in studying. Wherever I could fit it in. Here's the problem with that though. It's quality, it goes back to quality over quantity. When you start just trying to squeeze in studying or learning new things on top of your studies, on top of your full-time job, what this really does is, yes, you might be checking off the box that you're learning something new, but are you retaining it? Are you in an environment where it is best suited for learning? Are you learning at your optimal time? These are all things that we oftentimes just push to the side just to say we got it done almost versus quality and actually putting in the effort and energy when it is best suited. So what do I mean by that? Well, we all have an optimal time for learning. For example, for me, I learn best in the morning. I know after 3 p.m., yes, I'm definitely working still, but there's no way I'm going to be learning something new after 3 p.m. It's not going to, my brain will just not retain it. And there are so many studies around this that to work or study at your optimal time. And there's also a lot of studies that show to study right before actually, or learn something new before you go to sleep. For me though, even with all that data, I know what works best for me is to do it in the morning. And I really wanted to highlight that because some days you're not going to be able to do it all, and that is okay. Some weeks you might have a very long week at work or at school, and you're like, I'm getting so far behind in my learnings, what do I do? Well, here is what helped me. One is find a community. Find people to hold you accountable. So this might be either a Slack group you're part of, a Discord group you're part of, or maybe it's even just telling your friends and family what you are learning. And what this really does is it holds you accountable to learning. And not only does it hold you accountable, but you also get to share what you are learning, which really helps as far as reiterating your learnings and your skill sets and where kind of holes lie. The other thing this does is it hopefully, and if not, you need to do this, is set up a schedule, a learning schedule. And I really, really do not want you to be learning every single day on top of working, on top of studying, whatever the case may be. This is because you are going to burn out. It's just, you know, it's one of those things where working too much, having too much on your plate, it's like 1 + 1 = 2. It's going to happen. You need to enjoy your time learning, and this might result in learning less frequently, but when you do learn, you're actually putting more quality time into it. So for me, how I like to do it, as I've shared before in the past, is a few times a week in the morning, I will block off my schedule and learn whatever it is that I'm learning at the moment. And for me, learning is so important working in a full-time job as well, because as someone who is in developer relations, I'm speaking about new technology all the time. I'm speaking to developers, to engineers, so I need to understand what's coming up, what's going on, building with the latest technologies. And so it's very important for me to stay on top of all that. And I would burn out so quickly with my learnings if I was continuously learning every day, learning every weekend, all of that. You need time to breathe. Okay, groceries achieved. This brings me to, though, the most important thing that we circle back to that I mentioned at the beginning of the video, which is your why. Why are you learning something new on the side? See, I got into these chips a little bit already. Whether you're learning something new on the side or, you know, on top of your full-time job or on top of your studies, the why. You need to have a reason, no matter if you like it or not, as to why you are learning something new. And this is so important because at the end of the day, there are going to be times when the last thing you feel like doing is actually learning something new. And you need to have a very strong why in order to motivate you forward. Set you down here. The why goes back to, for me, what I do is I actually put on my phone. Where's my phone? It's over there. I have a vision board where it's actually what I want my life to look like. And in order to get that life, I'm not talking necessarily materialistic. Maybe it's through different experiences or things that come up. But in order to achieve that, this is the steps I need to take. And having that on my phone every single day, seeing it every single day, really motivates me for my why. And some days, as I mentioned, I might not even be motivated, it might be discipline, but you need to have that why really strong. I've actually been thinking of putting something like a vision board or something. I know it sounds kind of cheesy, but it's so true. Having this why will keep you motivated forward. And that is the biggest takeaway I hope you take from this video, is understand your why. And not only have a direct why, maybe not I want to get a promotion or I want to get a raise or whatever the case may be, but think about how that will affect your life long term. And when you start really painting a picture and a story of how this will affect your life, you go, whoa, this could, you know, spending a few extra hours each week will have a huge, huge impact on my life when I look ahead. And that makes it more impactful and more meaningful. Okay, I really hope this has given you some inspiration or motivation around when you are working in a full-time job, studying full-time, and you have things you want to learn on top of that. It is possible. Do not burn out. Do not try and overwork yourself into the ground, but rather take it day by day, find out your why, your big why, have that vision that you are going after, and then also to be kind to yourself. Break it down that you learn a few times a week. Have that schedule. Keep people around you that will not only hold you motivated and encourage you, but also hold you accountable. Leave in the comments any questions you have around this, what works best for you when you are balancing everything, and if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, and career-related content. Okay, I gotta go cook something now. Bye, everyone.